Allison Rosati, today on the Channel 5 News at 4.
Today on Danny.
How important is the perfect body to you?
It is my life.
Women obsessed with finding that perfect body face off with women who say big is beautiful.
I mean, I got more rolls than Pillsbury, baby, okay?
That a man likes my big behind.
Is it important to look perfect? Today on Danny.
Get started. I want everybody to know I am not playing with these dolls. These particular Barbies actually do have something to do with today's show. According to a recent survey, 90% of white women said they define their ideal beauty as 5'7" and weighing a mere 100 pounds. Barbie is their role model. On the other hand, 70% of black women said, I don't think so. Beauty is much more than that. And to quote my producer, Tracy, as a matter of fact, I can't quote Tracy. Tracy, come on out here, my producer, Tracy. I'm sorry, Tracy. I need some help with this. What is it?
Danny, as I told you, it's not the beauty, but the booty.
I'll tell you that. All right. Now, to further this argument, meet my first guest, the very Rubenesque Raven.
I'm big, I'm beautiful, and I'm bold.
God bless you, Raven. Please welcome the showstopper, Sheila.
Why settle for a snack when you can have a four-course meal?
Damn. Representing the other side of the coin is beauty number one, Bekkie. Come on out, Bekkie.
Dedication, Danny, in the gym and with my meal program, I'm going to have that perfect workout Barbie body.
And finally, meet the glamorous beauty number two, Chrystine. Come on out, Chrystine.
Well, Danny, I'm Chrystine, but I'm not my perfect size 3 yet. But with a little bit of workout and maybe some surgery, I'll be able to fit into this next summer.
Wow. Exactly, what is that?
It's a bathing suit. Would you like to try it on?
Talk to me after the show. Thank you very much. All right, let me ask all of you, do you all feel that you're beautiful?
Oh,
yeah,
of course.
Exactly. Beauty's inside. It's not what you have outside, it's what's inside that counts.
Right on.
You have to put inside, too, to get the results for outside. If you don't put good nutrition, if you're not good and healthy outside, it's going to show up on your outside.
Sheila,
you got to put it in, too.
Good for you. Sheila, let me ask. My mother told me I should never ask a lady this question, but how much do you weigh?
You know what? A woman who tells her weight and her age will say anything. But I am over 150 pounds. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Now, have any men ever complained about your weight, Sheila?
No. As a matter of fact, I wasn't always like this. I was a normal person. I was average, size 10, size 12, and I had a couple of babies. You know how it is, ladies. It's hard after you have a child.
I had 5 children.
What? You had 5
children? I have 5 children.
Damn.
So that is no excuse.
Good. That's talking about being 150 pounds. I'm 145.
Excuse me, I'm big, so. I'm bold, and I'm beautiful. And just because she's little, that doesn't mean that there's not people out there that love me for me.
All right.
How important is the perfect body to you? When you say take care of yourself, are you all natural? Did you work completely to get that body, or have you already been, as they say, under the knife?
No, I have to go into the gym. I work out 6-7 times a week, sometimes 3 times in the gym.
Chrystine, do you think that you have the perfect body?
Not at all. Not yet, but I will.
And what is that going to take? What are you willing to do to have the perfect body?
Some time in the gym, maybe going underneath the knife.
What would you have done plastic surgery-wise?
I would have I would have a breast enlargement done. After I've had children, it's a little bit different now than what it was
see,
before.
You, I had kids. When you're a big girl, you don't have to do breast enlargement.
Now you.
Yes, but I don't want the rest of me enlarged either, though. You know, it's not healthy either. I have children that I want to see grow up, and I want to see their children.
Well, who are you to say who's healthy and who's not?
The doctors will tell you.
Yeah, the doctor said there's nothing wrong with me. I'm healthy. Who are you to say?
You have doctor proof of this?
Yes, I do. Do you have doctor's proof of you?
Is there doctors in the audience who can tell
you? As a matter of fact, there is. As a matter of fact, there is a doctor in the house. Hang on a second. As I told you earlier, I am not an expert in beauty, so I have asked image consultant Dr. Sandra Goldberg to help me out, and you'll be watching throughout the show, and you'll tell us what you've come up with a little later on. All right, next. Find out why this young woman needs a Barbie doll nose. Take a look.
Some clothes you just don't want to put in the dryer, so you hang them up to dry. And that's the toughest test of any fabric softener, even Downy. So if you think any mid-priced brand can give you the softness of Downy, put your choice on the line. Look, those brands can leave clothes feeling stiffer after they've been line dried. But Downy gives your clothes a softer, fluffy feel. Come on in to the most fluffy softness. Come on in to Downy.
Sandy had an awful allergy attack.
Doctors say Dimetapp for good reason.
How are Dream Cafe, new from General Foods International Coffees.
And I'm around food all the time. When I first joined Jenny Craig, I was fat, I was heavy. I didn't know what kind of food I should be eating. And now I'm happy, I'm ecstatic. I can go past the mirror and say, that's me. I look good, oh my gosh. If I can lose the weight, if the job that I have every day around food, anyone can.
Chicago, start Jenny Craig now and you can lose 20 pounds for $20. Call 1-800-39-JENNY. That's 1-800-39-JENNY. Why wait another day?
Chicagoland, the sooner you call, the better you're gonna feel.
Statistic for you. Did you know that if Barbie was a human being, she'd be 7 feet tall and her measurements would be 38, 18, 28? All right, is it the beauty or the booty? I feel like Ricky, like every time I say that. Meet my next guest, Danielle. She says that all she's ever dreamed of is having that perfect Barbie doll nose. Danielle, what's wrong with your nose?
Well, I have one thing to say. I would love to have a Barbie doll nose just like hers. And I feel that Rudy is only skin deep, but I would love to have a Barbie doll nose. I feel nothing is wrong with my outer appearance as far as my body, but it's one thing I don't like is my nose.
Now, has this affected your whole life? I understand you didn't even take your high school picture.
Right.
Why not?
Because of my nose.
Excuse me, Danny. Excuse me.
Excuse me, Danny.
Yes, ma'am.
I think you're a beautiful girl, but have you ever took a look at Barbie's nose? There is no nose there.
Really? There isn't?
There's no nose there.
Well, I have something to say, too. Wait, I have something to say, too. Maybe you like the way you are, and I want to be the way I am.
Okay, that's fine and all, but there is no nose.
All right, now, let me ask you something. Danielle, are you planning on having plastic surgery to have your nose shaped just like that?
That's right.
We're using Barbie as an example, but that perfect little button nose?
That's right.
Well, who is to say that's perfect?
Yeah. What did you...
I mean, who is that?
You know what? We got your mother, Pat, right here in the audience. Pat, can I have my mic, please? Can I have my mic? Go wide. Come on. Todd, let's have it. Yikes. Whoa.
To say, everybody have their own opinion. Mm-hmm. I mean, just like you all, hey, you look good. If that's what you want, right. Fine. If she want her nose changed, fine. I'm behind her 100%.
Good for you. I'd like you to meet Jacqueline and her teenage beauty queen daughter, Heather. Jacqueline says she's been teaching her daughter that the more beautiful a woman is, the more powerful she is. Jacqueline, are you saying that beauty is power?
Well, to a certain point, I want you to understand this. You have to get the attention first. Everybody knows that. I mean, especially with men, you win, or jobs or anything. If you can't get the attention first, what's inside is the most important. And I truly believe that if you're a good person,
you could.
Good.
Jacqueline, what is it that you want for your daughter?
I'm sure she could.
What do you want for your daughter? I'm sure she got my attention. What is it you want for your daughter?
It's true. Once you get their attention, then they can learn what a wonderful person you are inside. If you're all frumpy and unattractive and you don't take care of yourself.
Hey, who's she referring to?
Get as far ahead. That's the way the world is now, whether you like it or not.
But it's what's inside.
That's
Let me just say that,
it is
Sheila,
what's
there's
inside,
nothing frumpy about either of you.
How are they going to see what's inside if they're not even going to look at you?
Now, Heather,
no, I'm really afraid here. One of the one things that she said was men. She said men, like she's preparing her daughter to be perfect for a man.
No, and that, for a job or for anything in life.
But it's all an image.
All right, hang on a second. Let's find out. Heather, would you mind? Would you mind terribly standing up and just seeing? Let us see you in your. Now it may not be what you're looking for, but let me just say. Do you consider that you have the perfect body?
No, of course not. I mean, everybody always has, you know, this perfect perspective in mind, and everybody always thinks, oh, you know, I can make this better, I can make this better, and I think the exact same thing, you
and
know?
And
I work out every day, and I take care of myself.
Has being beautiful helped you in other capacity, helped you in your life somehow?
Well, I model, so, you know, of course that helps me. But, of course, I want to get an education, I want to go to college, and I want to carry on with my life, and you know,
Heather's
beauty
a beautiful
does,
person
and
inside, besides being on the outside. It can't just be on the outside. It's true.
All right, thanks. Let's meet our next guest. I'd like you to meet Gail and her daughter, Camille. Gail says that she's raised her daughter with one belief, and that is the perfect body will get you the finer things in life. Gail, do you really believe that? Gail?
All right. Now, let's first define what we mean by perfect body. Okay?
Okay.
Mine. Health. Health first. You're not, if you don't have your health, you don't have anything.
All right, and let us meet Camille. Camille, do you mind standing up and letting us look at your beauty creme, your lovely
body?
Wow, absolutely lovely.
You know, the image of a perfect body can be that Coca-Cola bottle, as we talk about. Okay, yeah, yeah. All right.
Well, but
that kind of describes
different.
Ed McMahon, really.
Both of our points is, I don't have a problem with girlfriend down here at the end. Okay. If she feels as though.
Good to know.
No, I don't have a problem with her because of the fact that she can carry what she has.
Okay. Why not? I can't carry what I have.
Exactly. I don't have a problem with
you don't have a problem with me.
Right, I don't have a problem with that.
All right.
Let me just tell you. Have a problem with me.
Yes, ma'am.
Mine's more of a comment. For them two that's in the black, because you want a body that's perfect. Being natural, being beauty is just natural. That means not these fingernails, these weave hair. It's what you got inside. It's of course going to come outside. But unfortunately, you all do not have that. I'm sorry.
Well,
and I don't care if you want a breast reduction. It ain't gonna work, sweetheart,
because you
have it natural. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
If you can enhance yourself, being beautiful does come from inside. And I consider myself beautiful from inside, but if I can enhance my outside, I know that I'm going to get the better job.
And she has one life, and she ought to make it as good as she can.
Why can't
everybody
get the
has
same
one
job
life.
As you. What makes you better than me?
All right, Raven. Let me ask Raven and Sheila a question. What do you think about what you're hearing from the women who seek
physical perfection? I think it's pathetic because I think she mentioned she had 5 children, right?
Yes.
She looks
She's
great.
Spending all this money when she could be putting that money towards her children as a teacher.
All right, yes, ma'am.
My point is. I have 6, 7 on the way, okay?
Congratulations.
I think I look as bad as any one of y'all up there.
That's right.
Okay? Anyone. I think I can do what you're doing.
Okay.
Even though you got that dress on, put it on me. I bet y'all look better than you.
All right.
I got to take a quick break. Hold your questions. We'll be right back. I got to take a quick break. Next up, two women who say forget that Barbie stuff. The Bertha butt is better. Stay with us. You guys are rocking out.
Warning. This program may contain the following. Don't say we didn't warn you.
If you're a homeowner who wants out from under a pile of monthly debt, call Centennial Mortgage Company now.
I was in desperate need of financial help, and Centennial came through for me.
Instead of making a lot of payments per month,
now we only have to make one.
With our Centennial loan, we were able to get out from under the credit card crunch.
So if you need help, do what thousands of homeowners have already done. Call Centennial.
We save money with Centennial.
And you can too.
You are so beautiful to me.
Baby So Beautiful looks just like your baby, from her stunning eyes to her precious little smile. And everyone knows the most beautiful baby in the world is your baby.
You are. So beautiful to me.
Baby So Beautiful dolls from Playmates.
Sprint Sense International gives you great rates to countries all over the world. What more could you want?
How about some cash?
Cash would be good. Yes, some cash back.
Good point.
Presenting Sprint Sense International with something new, cash back. Call now for these simply great rates on calls to countries all around the world. Plus, get rewarded with 10% cash back for every dollar you spend.
For me, that would be at least $100 a year.
Cash back on all my calls to Ireland.
There's no limit to the amount of cash back you can earn. Month after month, you'll see your cash add up, so it pays to stay with Sprint. Call now and we'll even switch it for free.
What about domestic calls?
You'll get cash back on domestic calls, too. And with Sprint Sense International, you'll get a great 10 cents a minute rate on every state-to-state call. So call now.
Cash back would be great.
Good idea.
Cashback. Now that's one phrase that's understood around the world.
Get simply great rates now and 10% cash back every year. Call now. 1-800-979-8235.
Yeah, she's pretty.
I'm totally against Barbie. My mom was a feminist 20 years ago and never let me play with her.
Anybody that bases their parents on Barbie is out of whack.
Oh, I think she looks, out of proportion.
You know, 20-inch waist, 48-inch bust, and nobody looks like that. I wouldn't want my kids playing with her either.
And at all. None of Barbie's shirts fit her because her boobs are too big. Yeah. You can't even get the shirts on.
Wow. Apparently it is Bash Barbie Day here on Danny. My next guest says that her beauty is her booty, and she's proud of it. Meet belly dancer Nina Rose. Nina, you use your body to entertain. How do men respond to you?
I had to beat him off with a baseball bat because...
Oh, well, it must make you very popular.
I mean, I got more roles than Pillsbury, baby, okay? And I'm Puerto Rican Italian, totally confused, okay? All I know is you should be who you are, and beauty comes. Yeah. Beauty like soul. Beauty like soul comes from the heart.
Now, I know you've been listening backstage. So what do you think about what you've been hearing from our panel?
Well, I think that the mothers here, okay, need to allow these women to be who they want to be. It mm-hmm. seems to me is that those girls are who their mamas want them to be.
Right. Right.
Okay. Now, let me ask you this.
This is America.
Nina, would you prefer to be thin?
I became an overweight woman when I was 18 years old. And life began for me then, because then I could attract people with my sense of humor, my flair, my style, and then once they got beyond what they could see, they were able to feel.
Oh. Yes.
What can they see?
Well, what most people see is an overweight woman who is frumpy, dumpy, a term I heard backstage. But honey, if you shave your legs and your armpits and paint your fingernails and put your lipstick red. But everyone has a right to be who they are. That's a God-given gift.
I understand what Danny, she
She says she's a belly dancer. Now, yes. I've danced with a troupe and used to dance for 4 years, and most of the dancers I've seen are very slender because belly dancing is one of the best physical fitness things you can do for your body.
I eat in a Middle Eastern restaurant all the time. Whoa, here we go. My goodness gracious.
She's doing a lot more than belly dancing.
I'm telling you, because she was belly dancing
and doing the exercises that go along with it.
Everybody's body is different. Where's your bathing suit, girlfriend?
Hey. I'm not ready for it. Get in a bathing suit yet.
Why, honey? Are you ashamed of your body?
Yes, I am.
Why?
At this point, because I haven't got to
because society and some stupid man fed you the idea you were good enough.
Now I want you to meet someone very special whose booty, sassiness, and self-confidence got her own primetime TV series. She's a stand-up comedian and an actress. Please welcome my friend, Thea Vidal.
Sisters, you brave.
We must forget they don't
eat. That's
brave.
All right.
Yes, you can
see. Let's be real here.
All right, go, Thea. What do you think about what you've been hearing?
I have managed to be successful, and I ain't been a size 10 since I was 22.
Right on.
And let me tell you something. It is a wonderful thing to have a nice body. But I would ask you, why are you worried about your body when you need to worry about your mind?
Absolutely.
See, let me just tell you something. Let me tell you something. If I have a beautiful body, but my mind is messed up, ain't I still messed up? But see, you know what? My mind is clear. The God in me showed.
Oh.
My spirit is right. And I don't have to sleep by myself. I choose to when I want to. Well, I mean, I need to get you straight. You need to get straight. Now, see, it's nothing wrong with you having blonde hair and blue eyes and all of that. That's wonderful, baby. But see, we have to be realistic. This country said that black folk wasn't pretty ever. I've been a beautiful black woman all my life. So, no, your beauty is not my beauty. See, I like that a man likes my big behind. You don't have much of a behind.
I know, but
that's all right. Is your mind right?
Myself.
That's all right. You starve yourself?
No, I said I don't.
You don't. All right.
I eat constantly.
But you know what? I'm not worried about what you eat. I'm worried about what's in here. There's too many children bulimic and anorexic right now behind this mess, right up in here.
I didn't mean it like that, sister. But sister, I'm saying, embrace what I'm saying.
I understand
the concept
of beauty is distorted when you're not working
on
the inside. That's all I'm saying.
Let me have a sip.
Come here, baby.
You don't feel no bones now, do you, Danny boy?
I must say I am rather cozy.
Get on you next. Let me get you. Let me just say one thing.
You asked about her nose backstage. You think there's something wrong with her getting cosmetic surgery?
When I woke up this morning, I was a black queen.
There you go.
And when I lay down tonight, I'm gonna be a black queen. And there's something beautiful about that big black nose. See, that's Africa, baby. That's Africa. We're the first people under the sun. Civilization began with us. And if that's what God gave you, You better praise him.
God bless him. Next up, meet a man who says, now listen to me, this is important. I want you guys to hear this clearly. Next up, meet a man who refuses to date within his own race because he says the women aren't beautiful enough. Stay with us, man.
My nose. I think I'd be about 4 inches taller. I'd have the same change, just to be a little bit taller. My weight.
I wouldn't change anything.
Will this person's laundry pass the Gain Show and Smell Challenge? Let's find out.
Hi, I'm the Gain Man. What's your name?
Laura Whitehead.
You've tried Gain, right?
Yes.
What's your favorite thing about it?
Oh, the way it smells and how fresh it is. It reminds me of flowers.
We're inside Laura's house now. She's invited us in to smell some things. Laura, how did your laundry look after you wash it in Gain?
Clean, fresh. It really, you can tell right here.
It sure looks clean. That smells fresh. Well, that's not just plain clean, that's peekaboo clean. Congratulations, Laura and Christopher. You guys have passed the Gain Show and Smell Challenge. How's that feel?
My baloney has a first name. It's O-S-C-A-R with B-O-L-O-G-A.
If you've been injured in any kind of accident, Injury Helpline lawyers will work to get you money. Call the Injury Helpline toll-free and speak with a lawyer near you. Our lawyers are paid only when you collect your money. If you don't collect, you don't pay. Call the Injury Helpline now. Time may be running out. We're here to help accident victims get money for their injuries. Call 1-800-526-0005.
If a better body came in a can, or from a box, or on a video, you'd already have one. So stop kidding yourself and join the club that lets you start getting in shape for $5. Bally Total Fitness. It's easy, because no other health club gives you more for your money. State-of-the-art equipment, classes, all for $5. It's the best health club value in America. So skip the drinks. Start getting the body you want right now for $5. Call Bally Total Fitness at 1-800-WORKOUT. But hurry, this offer ends soon.
The jobs of tomorrow are here, thousands of them, waiting to be filled. But you have to know the fields they're in, and you have to have what it takes to master those fields. Because you can't get the jobs of tomorrow until you get the skills of today. Start by calling ITT Technical Institute. We'll send you an informative brochure on tomorrow's careers and what it takes to get them. Call 1-800-942-0088.
Before I introduce my next guests, who have been kind enough to join us, I've got to give Bekkie a chance to respond. Bekkie and Chris and Jacqueline, Heather, Gail, Camille, all of you have been kind of, if you will, attacked a little bit. How do you feel about what you're hearing?
Well, you know, it upsets me to hear that, you know, she may be spiritual, I'm spiritual too, and anyone who praises God, God is with them for one. Two, and I do eat. I keep a list of diet to make sure that I do eat enough food. I have got to eat enough food. So I write down just to make sure that I can consume food.
Food is not the issue.
You're missing what I said.
Yeah. Food is not the issue.
But also, it's strict about having a healthy, fit mind. You have to have a healthy, fit body if you want a healthy, fit mind.
That's wrong.
Hang on, I got to give these ladies a chance to respond.
Okay, go ahead,
you had something you wanted to say. Please go ahead.
Go down the line. Come on, girlfriends.
You were giving her a bad time about African noses, and you love your nose and everything.
Pay attention, it was that one.
And her over there, and she wanted to get her nose taken care of, and everybody was giving her a hard time.
Taken care of?
And how awful that was. But I want to tell you something. She comes out here, she's a comedian, she's trying to get all this attention, hoot and holler.
Hang on, wait till they're done.
Hold your talk down. Show everybody your big old tattoos you got all over your breast.
They're mine.
I want to tell you something. What about tattoos?
Excuse me.
All right, let's give Heather one shot. Okay, you've got very little.
It's ugly and it's wrong.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Wait a minute. Did you say tattoos? Wait, excuse me one second. Did you say tattoos are ugly and wrong?
The great ones are. Yeah. She has great big ones all she picked
I gotta agree.
Outfit.
I gotta agree to that.
The whole audience. I mean, that's.
All right. It's time to meet my next guest. It's time to meet my next guest. Hang on 1 second. Hang on, Thea. You're going to have a chance. I'm sure you'll find a chance. Is it the beauty or the booty? Now, we've heard from the women. It is time to hear what some of the men have to say. Let's meet Denzel right here. Denzel.
I'll get you.
Ken, you've been dating Chrystine for how long now?
Over a year and a half.
Over a year and a half. And how do you feel about what you've been hearing out here?
Well, what I've been hearing is, you know, it's only skin deep, you know, okay? The beauty on the outside.
I'm sorry, Chrystine, would you raise your hand? Somebody knows who we're talking about.
Right.
Like that.
Chrystine's right down there. She is very beautiful on the inside as well on the outside. And that's what attracted me to her the first time.
Is she doing this just to please you?
No, she's not doing it just to please me. It's to please herself.
If she got fat, would you still stay with her?
If she got fat, yeah.
No.
Lionel, you've been dating Sheila. Sheila, raise your hand. Somebody knows who you are. Okay, I'll stand up.
It's me.
Now, Sheila was not always this size. How did you react when she first put on the weight?
There was no way to react. I mean, it just happened. Yeah! She's still the same person who I met years ago.
What do you love about her the most?
I love everything about it.
No, what's the one particular thing? Truthfully.
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 We won't go there.
No.
But she's the same person I met, you know?
And let us meet Denzel. Now, Denzel, what kind of women are you? You don't even know yet.
Boo.
Denzel, what kind of women are you attracted to?
Slim women. Boo. Slim. In particular, white. The reason being.
I have it right here on my little card. It says he only dates white women.
That's true? That's true.
How do we feel about
that's
that?
That's true.
Yes, ma'am.
First, I'd like to say my name is Lynette, okay? I'm an African-American queen. I'm a full-figured model. I work for Ashley Stewart, okay? My weight is not a burden. It's my joy, okay? I get paid for being full-figured, okay? This gentleman,
Denzel?
And I'm being kind by calling him a gentleman.
Uh-oh. Looks bad for you.
Came to the show from New York with Raven and myself.
Oh, okay.
Okay? He was completely intimidated by us,
didn't open
the door. He was not a gentleman. We got in a limousine together. Didn't open the door, didn't ask us, you need help with your baggage. Didn't look in our face.
That's the best limo man, so I didn't look at y'all.
I sensed that this
I couldn't
was
miss y'all.
That was him from the show.
Excuse me, can I have this very heavy weapon back? All right, well, that was very fun. What a good time was that,
Miles. Can I say something
to him?
Real quick, because I got to go.
He said that he didn't like, he thought black women were ugly. What color is your mother?
When we come back, we'll hear from an expert right here who's going to tell us why black and white women don't always see eye to eye when it comes to beauty. Stay with us. You're
eyes, definitely her eyes.
Eyes.
Probably her hair.
Hair.
Smile. Smile.
I look at the whole woman, but I look at her face first.
Legs.
Shape.
Eyes.
No, not the shape, how she's dressed in her shape.
From the Channel 5 newsroom.
At 4 o'clock, the story of Richard Walski, the youngest person ever to receive an artificial heart.
He's a young man accustomed to medical miracles, and now he's hoping for one more as his race against time begins.
Today at 4 on the Channel 5 News, committed to Chicago.
Looking for the perfect mate? We investigate matchmakers or heartbreakers, plus the beauty secrets of Hollywood's leading men of the next hard copy.
Today at 3:30 on NBC5.
I only have one dad. He's a great guy, an active guy. But as a result of his diabetes, he developed a wound that just wouldn't heal. He said he could live with it, but I couldn't.
The Wound Care Center can help. We use advanced techniques and therapies you just can't find anywhere else.
You should have seen his face when he walked in the door.
Call the Wound Care Center at 1-800-747-2233.
Are you ready to be excited, exhilarated, and completely entertained? Then get ready for a workout with cable. Feel the action of sports. Be there as news happens. Get in on all the laughs. Cable really entertains you and takes you to the edge.
So, how do I get there?
You gotta call. But you gotta call now, because this great offer won't last forever.
I want more.
Get premium TV. It's nonstop. Showtime is action-packed. HBO is pure excitement. The movie channel is your movie ticket. Cinemax really moves you. Call 1-800-CABLE-ME, because now installation's just $9.95 when you order cable. Plus, get two premium channels for the price of one for 1 month, and get $50 worth of coupons from Home Shopping Network. Cable and premium TV for the most entertaining workout your money can buy.
Yeah!
On tomorrow's Danny.
So what made you decide to pose naked?
We're turning up the heat with calendar hunks and babes.
Well, I look like you have totally posed naked. No, you can't keep pants on me.
From Houston's sexiest firefighters who drive our audience wild.
I hate it when that happens.
To the women of Hooters. It's 12 months of beautiful bodies.
Let me see if I've got this right. I've got half-naked firemen, Playgirl's man of the decade, and a naked lady hanging by a chain. I think I can wing it.
On tomorrow's Danny.
And we are talking about the wide discrepancy between the way black women and white women see themselves. According to a recent survey, 90% of white women say they're unhappy about the way they look, where 70% of black women say they're very pleased with the way they look. What is going on there? Now, back real quick to Denzel. Denzel, why don't you date black women?
I'm gonna tell you, a lot of the black guys, they settle for this. You know, they settle for this bigness.
Oh, my God.
My mother's a black woman.
Look at this figure right here. She's beautiful.
My mother's similar to that. And she's in her 50s. But she took care of herself.
Wait a minute. Am I the wrong color?
All right, Denzel White.
But like I said, more white women, they try to you know, keep themselves in shape. They try to keep themselves, you know, doing positive things.
Now, wait a second. I'll come to you. There's nothing wrong with you.
I don't know what's wrong with me.
There ain't nothing wrong with you, baby.
Your black and white issue.
At this present time, right now, I am dating a white man, but I date all men. All men love me.
Regardless. Wait a minute. You date all men regardless of race, creed, or color.
That's right.
The Rainbow Coalition, like all by herself. Right on.
I got tired of running into that dead end. It was always a dead end.
Excuse me, let me just say this.
All right, see ya, go, baby.
Hold on, let me just say this. Because first of all, go ahead. Let me just talk, sister.
Let's have Thea have a shot.
Okay,
go ahead.
First of all, this right here is what's wrong with our people right now. Hold on. When we talk about...
No, I disagree.
You have a self-hate factor that you need to work through. And the reason why you like to be with white women is because white women have a tendency to be more passive than sisters.
We've got to dodge doctor in the house. Joining us is body image consultant Dr. Sandra Goldberg. Dr. Goldberg, stand up for me. How are you, doc?
Fine, thank you, sir. How are you?
Good. As a doctor, what the hell is going on here?
I have to tell you, this has been one of the most interesting evenings that I have spent in my entire life.
Me too.
And when you were talking about the business about white women and black women, let me tell you, ladies, first of all, you are all magnificent.
Thank you.
Thank you, doc.
It doesn't matter what color you are. It doesn't matter if you weigh 400 pounds or if you weigh 100 pounds. It is how you feel about yourself. Now let's address. I have to tell you, I've been sitting here, and the energy on this stage has built and built and built and built. And I'll deal with you all, too. Don't worry about that.
You get it.
First of all, in addition to being an image consultant, I have a PhD in nutrition. So when everybody was talking about the proper way to eat and the healthy way to eat, and the way in which our bodies are evidenced by what we put into it, I agree. The problem that I have, and I deal with eating disordered people, and when you were talking about anorectics, and when you were talking about bulimics, what we are talking about is the way we feel about ourselves.
Right.
Now, I have people said to me, for heaven's sakes, what do you know, middle-aged Jewish lady wearing size whatever it is you are?
But you look good, girl.
You look good, Doc. I gotta give you that.
Let me share something with you, and I don't know whether or not you know that either. I've lost 160 pounds.
And I did not know that. Bravo. Bravo. Congratulations. By the way, I don't know if you know this, but I've lost 42.
You are so hated.
But you know what's important? It's off 22 and a half years. And whenever I get up and I talk to people, they say, did you define yourself in terms of the size of your body? And my answer was, yes. Yes, I did. And why? Because I was not comfortable with myself.
Right.
That is the important thing.
Right. Can I say something?
Sure.
But what if you are? Why not?
Guys,
I'm happy the way I am, and I don't think that I need a diet and nutrition. Let me be. I love myself. I'm confident.
I got to take a few questions from the audience is out of their mind. If I don't start taking questions, I'm going to get killed. So if you don't mind, sit down for a second, listen so you can come back to you. You've been dying to talk all night. Go ahead.
This is for Denzel.
Uh-oh, Denzel.
You disgust us. Me. You know what I'm saying? Man, as a black brother, all what we done been through, you gonna deny our black queen. How could you sit there on national TV and say something like that? I can't understand it. That is the problem out here now. Every black man wanna go put a white woman on their side and forget where they came from. Forget everything we done been through. It's disgusting.
Let Denzel respond. Go ahead, man. I want you to know you're not out here to be attacked, man. Whatever it is, that's my opinion.
I've dated black women. I don't like the way it's being ran.
Yeah, we found it.
White women,
it's
better.
Hang on, Lionel has another chance. Go ahead, buddy.
For so long, like Thea said, we thought we were ugly. You know what I'm saying?
No.
America has fed us that we were ugly as a race of people, but now we are seeing. Hey, it's not true. All right. That was lies. We were always beautiful. But you have some who are not happy with themselves.
All right.
And they want to be other than who they are.
All right. Amen.
One day he's going to find himself, and he may find that black, beautiful queen that's going to make him happy.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
I'd like to say, not only are you colorblind to your race, but look at your clothes. You are very beautiful, and I think that if that's what makes you happy, make yourselves happy, don't listen to your moms.
Thank you.
Well, no. You know, there's been a lot of that. Let me just say something real quickly. That, by the way, we talked about if you're all right in your mind and how you feel, but there's nothing wrong as long as you're okay and you're with being gorgeous, beautiful, and thin. That's good, too. That is fine. Stay with us. You'll hear more. I don't know where we're going, but we'll be back. Whoa.
I would say in everyday life, yeah. I mean, you get better service in restaurants, you get waited on faster in retail stores. I mean, pretty is what counts, I guess.
In a lot of different ways, they get treated better, you know. They're waited on faster. If their cars break down or somebody will stop from faster.
This is new Moisture Whip Lipstick, only by Maybelline. Smoother. More seductive. Now more moisturizing with vitamin E and aloe. New Moisture Whip.
It does for your lips what the French did with a kiss.
Maybe she's born with it.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
For healthier, shinier hair, I say start at the bottom with Pantene Pro-V Daily Conditioners. This was how I used to deal with split ends. Now, I help stop them before they start. Pantene's Pro-Vitamin formula actually penetrates down to the tips, restoring your hair, making it healthier, shinier. Split ends? Try and find them.
Pantene Pro-V Conditioners every day for hair so healthy, it shines.
See you later, split ends.
The New York Times, Rolling Stone, Newsweek, USA Today, and Siskel and Ebert all agree. And on September 15th, one of the most critically acclaimed films of the year returns to the screen for a special limited theatrical engagement. Mel Gibson, Braveheart, rated R. Limited engagement starts Friday, September 15th at select theaters.
Champion Covey Tucker Hill, Stormy Breyer, four-time winner, best in show. Champion Krishana.
The dogs and cats you see here have two things in common. They're all top champions, and they're all fed ProPlan brand pet food. Experienced breeders have been feeding ProPlan for years. It helps make their dogs and cats look and feel great and perform at their peak. ProPlan is available at pet stores, feed stores, and veterinarians. Start feeding ProPlan soon and treat your pet like a champion.
I'd like an onion and poppy.
How about a whole wheat and an everything? These aren't bagels.
Hey, no holes.
Presenting new Manischewitz-flavored matzos. Delicious fat-free crackers in your favorite bagel flavors. Made from the finest ingredients in original and new snack sizes.
Mm. Hey, give me a savory garlic.
Give him a plain. I don't even miss the holes.
New Manischewitz-flavored matzos. Great bagel taste, great cracker crunch.
Man, oh, Manischewitz.
Beauty and how important it is and why black women and white women see it so differently. And to be honest with you, I don't know. I don't know if anybody mentioned this to you, but I'm whiter than Richie Cunningham.
No kidding.
So I don't know. Doctor, stand up again for me, would you please? Dr. Goldberg, do you have an answer for any of this, why black and white women see beauty so differently?
Sure I do. Take a look at the models in the magazines. Exactly. Most of the white models in the magazines have been airbrushed, been computer retouched.
Right.
Now, who are the images that the black women are looking at? The models that are there have been retouched.
Naomi.
That's right.
Naomi. Tyra, but look else. Look at Mae Jemison. Look at Oprah. Look at you. You know,
right,
so we're talking about differences in role models. We're talking about differences in image. We're also talking about the fact, I think, which has not been addressed, is where women are going now. White women came first in terms of attempting to crack the glass ceiling, and the perception was we have to look a certain way. Mm-hmm. A lot of the black women are still coming up through the floor. What's going to happen? Why not our own individuality? I think that's the big difference.
Right. Let me ask the ladies, who are some of your role models? Do you have any role models? Go ahead.
I like Thea. Because I think...
I do, too.
I think that she's right on point, and I've watched all her shows.
Thank you.
She does a really great job.
Cher is my role model.
Cher is your role model? Now, you know, she's had a lot of classes.
Yeah. And doesn't she look wonderful?
No, she's had... you know, she does look wonderful, but she's had so much plastic surgery. When she sits down, her mouth slams shut. Right here, yes, ma'am. We have a question, please.
Heather, are you happy? Are you happy with your mother?
I'm very happy. You know what? I was never raised that beauty got you far. Never. Mm-hmm. None of my sisters are this skinny, beautiful. They're all successful.
Do you have problems with proud mothers?
All of them make plenty of money. All of them have beautiful children.
You want to know what problem I have?
I'm going to call
in. I do have a problem.
You're being a nurse?
She's a lot better person.
My mom's a cosmetologist.
Who are you to judge her to say that she's a better person than her?
Excuse me. I do have a problem. I have a problem with you.
Calling her a Barbie doll, making her feel like she's a blonde.
You made me feel very bad. You made me feel very, very bad. You offended me so bad at the beginning of the show when you said you said that for people to see their inner beauty, they have to be beautiful on the outside first.
No, that's
a bull. I'm sorry, ma'am.
You have to get the Danny, let me
just say this one thing. This one thing, because I mean,
I just said first impression.
Go ahead, let's see.
Excuse me. I have tattoos on my body because this is my body. And the tattoos, and you made a reference point to me coming out here being so grand. First of all, I came out here because I'm the celebrity that they
picked. No, I said that they made fun of her nose.
I'm speaking now.
Heard one.
And I'm trying to give you respect,
and you did,
but I can disrespect you. Listen, I'm not saying.
Why don't you stop embarrassing white people and give her a chance to stop showing your ignorance?
Go ahead.
Black issue. This is supposed to be a health and fitness issue, not
this
a white, black issue.
Well,
this you guys made it
what is
issue.
Beauty and what is not? Hold on. The tattoos
beauty
are not
is
the issue on my body.
You. Inside
it's
you.
Me. And
that's
furthermore,
right.
yeah,
what's inside,
I am a grand
not on
woman.
You know what?
I'm a
you know what?
Woman,
excuse me one,
you know
second,
what?
One second. I'm going to have to insist now, one
Thank
at
you.
A time. Okay?
Thank
I have to. I'm sorry. I got to be able to hear the answer. Thea. Go ahead, Thea.
First of all, there's no reason for any of us to be angry at each other.
That's right.
We can all agree to disagree.
That's
but
right.
you need to know from me as one woman to another, I allow no woman to disrespect me.
There you go.
And furthermore, these tattoos are mine, and they were my decision. And no, people can judge me. They judge me by the color of my skin before they judge me by the fact that I'm a woman. I've been judged
Why would they do
since
that?
The beginning of time.
Why?
My people have been judged
Shut
from the
up,
beginning man. Of time. So the fact that I got tattoos is just one more thing yeah. they was going to judge me on anyway.
Let me give you a chance. Go ahead.
Okay,
go
it has
ahead.
Nothing to do with if you want them on you. I'm saying the way you came out pulling your blouse down.
It's not a blouse.
Let her talk.
Pulling your top down in front of everybody here and then mentioning what a good Christian woman you were. And then when she was saying she'd like to get her nose fixed, everybody was putting her down and yet saying that that's doing harm to your body, and yet I feel doing tattoos is doing harm to your body.
Well, and the reason why she got the nose is because she wants to be.
All right, here we go.
No,
Bad, you have something to say. Hang on, we have a question from the audience.
Yeah,
question from the audience. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Any mom would stick up for her daughter if somebody was putting their daughter down.
You're right. Am I right? You're right about that. Pat, go ahead. Hang on.
Would your mom stick up for you if somebody was putting her down?
If you're blonde,
you're stupid. Pat, you have a question.
You said that now.
You know, that is not cute.
Hi.
You know, you make a
calm everybody down.
Go ahead, girlfriend.
First of all, let's not dog the mamas because they want their daughters to be beautiful. Because
right.
I'm a mama and I want my baby to be pretty.
All right.
And when I grow up, I want to be just like them. But that's when I grow up. And my old boy over there, I'm 43 years old, got 6 grandbabies, ain't took one exercise. But because most black women know how to cook, that's why they are healthier than other people.
All right, stay with us. We will be right back. Don't go anywhere. I'm going to get to all of you.
Looking to find the perfect mate? Hard Copy goes undercover inside a matchmaking service, and you may be shocked by what we found. They say the more desperate you are, the more you pay. It's a special investigation into matchmakers or heartbreakers. Plus, could some of Hollywood's hottest leading men share the same beauty secret?
I think a lot of the names would definitely surprise people.
Meet the doctor who says these stars may be artificial hunks on Hard Copy.
Today at 3:30 on NBC5.
During some sales, you can save on one or two kinds of carpet. But during Empire's anniversary sale, every single carpet we have is on sale. And we'll bring them right to your home. Crush resistant, stain resistant, every brand, every style, they're all on sale. Including padding, including installation. With no monthly payments till February. Empire's anniversary sale. It's the only sale of the year where every carpet is on sale.
800-588-2300 Empire.
Hello, America. Remember me? I am Alice Scott, and I lost 37 pounds on Jenny Craig. Listen, before I lost a single pound, I started with a phone call. Before I went down 4 dress sizes, before I got that job, I started with a call. A call to Jenny Craig. And you can do it just like I did, you guys, starting with a call.
Start Jenny Craig now and you can lose 20 pounds for $20. Call 1-800-39-JENNY. That's 1-800-39-JENNY. Why wait another day?
Pick up that phone and call this number. You see it. You see it.
You are so
so beautiful, from her stunning eyes to her precious little smile. Baby So Beautiful is your baby. That's because Baby So Beautiful looks like your baby. She's got her hair, eyes, and almost everything else about her. Everyone knows the most beautiful baby in the world is your baby.
You're everything.
You are so beautiful to me. Baby So Beautiful dolls from Playmates.
Hey, Danny Bonaduce here. If you plan to be in the Chicago area, I've got a great idea for you. Come and be a part of my show. The tickets are free and you'll have a great time. So call 312-604-TALK. That's 312-604-TALK. Talking big, small, black, white. Dr. Goldberg, what is it really all about?
It's an issue of self-esteem. If you feel good about yourself, you're going to present yourself positively to the world. You all look wonderful. Just feel good.
All right, good enough. Let me just say in closing, I've dated women of all shapes and sizes, and if I love them and they love me back, that's all it was about for me. Thank you very much to my panel, each and every one of you. Thank you to you. Thank you, Sarah. Thank you all. Bye.
New Alberto VO5 Naturals. Four fragrant shampoos and conditioners with natural extracts. For beautiful hair in the purest sense.
In a taste test between Fiber One and Kellogg's All Brand, twice as many people preferred the light, crispy taste of Fiber One. Fiber One, the one that tastes better.
The Armatron Reversible Bracelet Collection. Flip the bracelet and change from an elegant gold tone design to a fashion-forward silver tone timepiece. The perfect gift idea from Armatron.
It's a brand new season on Springer. They're kids living on the streets. Now Jerry reunites these homeless kids with the family and friends they left behind. Next, Jerry Springer.
Jerry Springer, next on NBC5.
It's a new day at Jewel and Oscar. Because now, Chicago's best food store and best drug store are teaming up like never before to bring you more store-wide values, more store-wide savings, and a greater level of shopping convenience. It's the kind of news we hope will brighten everyone's day. Jewel Osco, working together to serve you better.
In 1920, Louis Darvin went into the furniture business providing personal service, good quality, and low prices. Today, 75 years later, that tradition is still the focus of all Darvin family efforts. Darvin customers know they can find quality manufacturers like Thomasville, Pennsylvania House, Century, Lane, Bassett, Serta, and more in the largest selection under one roof in Chicagoland. They know they'll experience the same warm personal service Darvin was founded on. Darvin Furniture, on LaGrange Road in Orland Park. Easy to get to from anywhere in Chicagoland.
This program may contain the following. Don't say we didn't warn you.
Hi,
Hi, welcome to the show. This is Tara and this is Shalana. They are both 17 years of age. And Tara, for example, has been living on the streets since she was 14. Today, we're going to talk to them and kids like them who live on the streets and find out what life is like. How do they survive and why are they out there in the first place? You want to go inside now? We'll talk to you in just a moment, okay? Okay. What Tara doesn't know, and the kids like them, is that today we are going to reunite them with someone very dear to them that they left behind when they first hit the streets. It ought to be good. Stay with us. Everybody. Okay. You still don't get any food, all right? Hey, about this time of the year, most 17-year-old girls are thinking about what they are going to wear on their first day of school and not where they're planning to sleep and seek shelter for the night. I'd like you to meet Tara. Tara, you see, has been living on the streets for 3 years. Sitting next to her is her friend Shalana, who is also a street kid. Tara, let me start with you. Describe that first night you're out on the streets. Where did you go?
First night was rad. No, it was like, I'm sorry, it was rad.
No. The first night was rad.
It was cool. I had
fun. Oh, it's, yeah, like radical? I'm so cool. Go ahead.